Gentlemen, you both wrote legislation that is now law, which would ban the purchase and use of Chinese-made drones by government agencies here in Arkansas. Senator Boyd, let me start with you. Why did you write that law?
Well, I think it's important that when you have a Chinese military-funded organization and they control 80% of the market, you have to give other opportunities out there for privacy and security.
It's a common sense piece of legislation. At the end of the day, safety and security is the number one purpose of being in the state legislature and hopefully our number one goal in all legislation that we pass. Chinese-made drones pose a threat. At the end of the day, they are a military-subsidized company by the CCP. We're taking, like Senator Boyd said, cues from not only Department of Defense, Department of Commerce, Department of Interior, who've all grounded their Chinese-made fleets. Arkansas has not been devoid of cyber attacks or cybersecurity issues, and we need to do what we can to protect not only our state agencies, but all of our departments and police departments all across the natural state.
You viewed it as a homeland security risk?
I do. And again, we can't work for the entire United States, but we took our cues from the Department of Defense, who has banned the use of Chinese-made drones, and we said, what can we do in Arkansas? And so we can say you can't use public dollars to purchase Chinese or Russian-made drones.
What kind of reception have you received since this bill was signed into law in April?
There's been mixed emotion, and I understand that. And that's the best part of being a legislator is you get to hear both sides of any legislation that you propose. We're hearing from cybersecurity experts, former Homeland Security experts that say that we're on the right track. We're ahead of the curve in terms of other states and other legislatures that are taking up this issue. We've also heard from heads of local police departments and sheriff's departments in that these drones that they're using that are manufactured by Chinese-based or Russian-based companies or manufactured companies are critical to their day-to-day function. And we don't disagree with that assertion. We think it's vitally important what these things do. It's just we have to take one step further in securing the safety, privacy, and protection of all Arkansans.
We interviewed Sheriff Runyon from Sebastian County this morning. He says he respects both of you. I think he's really good friends with you, Senator. But he said that this is very hypocritical, that we have iPhones in our pockets that are potentially made in China, even though some of that production is now going to India. We have electronic devices, smart TVs in our homes that are made in China.
I mean, this is on a list. The American government, the Department of Defense has identified as a concern. And, you know, a lot of things I'm buying personal. We didn't ban personal drones. We just said we're not going to use state dollars to put Arkansans at risk.
I want to make sure that the process of talking with, you know, sheriffs and sheriff's deputies and police chiefs and swift water survival groups, that was a part of the legislative process. And that's why we did add in a 4-year window for these existing drones to still be used and utilized under current law. And the process for an exemption to be granted by the Secretary of Transformation in the state of Arkansas. So again, we agree that these are mission critical pieces of infrastructure. And that a lot of departments and entities have spent money in these drones that are part of their day-to-day mission. They should still be able to, utilize them if there is a exigent need or circumstance that allows them to do that. So we completely understand, and that was a part of the process. And we drafted the bill and we amended the bill so that we were taking in some of those inputs from sheriff's departments and police departments all across the state.
Originally, it was 2 years that agencies would have to phase out their use of these drones. You've extended it to 4 years. I think there was a compromise with law enforcement in the legislative process. But let me just ask you, Representative, I'll start with you. Is there any money from the state for agencies to replace drones they may have already purchased?
No, not currently, but that's also part of the process, is that there isn't been money appropriated for the purchase of them. These departments have gone out of their own volition and, you know, institutionalized the need for these within their existing budgets, as well as found reasons to increase millages in certain counties or local taxes to help support the need for the mission of drones, not drones specific to China. So, no, there is not additional appropriation, but there wasn't an appropriation for the drones in the first place.
So neither one of you, just to be clear, intends to introduce legislation that would have a buyback program, for example. Agencies that may have purchased these drones, now they want to replace them, no buyback program on the horizon.
I would say is, again, this legislation sends a strong signal to the drone market for American and allied made drones. And I'm confident that the markets are going to scale accordingly. Quality is going to go up, price is going to go up, you're going to see more competition. Right now, 80%, or depending on which segment of the market, up to 90% of the market is by a Chinese subsidized company. And that puts America at risk. It puts Arkansans at risk. And this legislation is a first step in dealing with that. Again, as Representative McKenzie said, there is that release. If there's a real issue, then the Secretary of Transformation can issue an exception to the rule. We have a four-year window which you can continue to operate, which should get the life of most of the drones, if not all of the drones, in that are already in operation. And it gives the market the opportunity to scale. And then, of course, in Arkansas, we meet every 2 years. If there's another opportunity where we need to modify because something didn't happen as we thought it might in the market, there is that opportunity. But I'm very confident that, again, what we're going to see is scale, and prices are going to come down, quality is going to go up as competition is introduced.
Have either of you seen with your own eyes data going from a drone to China?
No, not specifically, but part of the process of introducing this legislation, I had countless conversations with sheriffs and everyone of the like from all over the state. And this, that question was posed to me frequently. And the question I was posed back is, can you guarantee a backstop of the information that you are collecting on these drones so that it goes on no other network other than your own? And to a person, no one could answer yes. So, albeit I understand and respect that this may seem like a mythical creature that exists out in the wilderness, it is true. We have seen cybersecurity threats in the state of Arkansas. And we need to do everything we can from emerging technology to make sure that that information is not finding its way to Beijing.